It's Monica with Scrapping for My Boys. So I'm back with another flower feature series video. I know it's been a couple of months since I last did one, and I'm trying to get back into the swing of things. I do have flower samples for you. I'm not going to assemble a flower on this video like I do in some of my other videos because it's pretty much the same, but I'll briefly go over my shaping technique again for those of you who want to see it. Again, it's nothing fancy. I don't do any type of, you know, I don't use any of the stylus tools to shape the petals and do all that stuff. I ain't got time for that. So I do very, very basic shaping. So I will show you, I just won't assemble a flower in the video. My kids are downstairs playing. My door is open. So if you hear the commotion and the racket in the background, my apologies, but kids will be kids and they're playing Fortnite right now. Okay, so let me go ahead and get my sign out of the way and I'll bring the dies in and we can go ahead and start talking about the dies. So this is a new company that you're seeing on my channel. So here are the items that are part of this range. John Next Door is a new brand created by John Lockwood. He has a blog. He's been a blogger. He's from the UK. He does gorgeous, gorgeous cards. If for those of you who don't know who he used to be on the Sue Wilson design team, or it could have been the Creative Expressions design team, but he did a lot of work with Sue Wilson Dyes, and that's how I found out about him. But about a year ago, I believe in 2018, he branched out and he created his own line. His line is not manufactured by Creative Expressions like Sue Wilson's is. His is manufactured by Crafts 2. Now, John Next Door is the name of his brand. It's also his blog. I'll have his blog linked in the description box below in case you guys want to go check out his cards. Fabulous stuff. And he does a lot of samples, a lot of promoting of all of his different dyes. So this is a relatively new brand. It's only been around for, I want to say, a year, year and a half. And I've had my eye on them. I just haven't bought anything. The reason main being is, as of right now, you can only find this in the UK. You cannot find this brand in any stores here in the States, which is a bummer because a lot of people don't like to shop overseas. Shopping overseas, shipping can be pricey depending on what store you're purchasing from. I do shop from the UK. There's plenty of companies that sometimes for quicker release, it's easier to get it through the UK. For example, like Tonic. Tonic is a brand that it takes forever for their newer designs to come over across the, you know, the sea and make it to the States. Even though they have a US site, it does take a long time. So brands like Tonic is one that I do shop from the UK specifically. John Next Door is another one. As far as the video is concerned, it's only going to be about these flowers, but I will touch really quickly. Pricing on the dyes, some of them can be pricey, some of them are priced relatively well. It kind of all just depends. Again, it's a newer brand. They're still getting their foot out, you know, into the world. I have played with these. I do have a sample of the flowers to show you. There are a few pros and cons. They're not really that big of a deal. For the price point that these are, it's not a problem. So like Sue Wilson, he releases his dyes in collections and different types of things. Like the flower comes from the Christmas collection. Things like Sue Wilson has finishing touches, which is all like the greenery and added little tidbits that you put on cards. He also has a similar type of thing. His is called the Editions range. So you'll find his things in collections as well. He has released tons of dyes, but this is the first thing that I've really, really, really wanted that I finally got my hands on. I have been after this poinsettia die since it was released last year. I believe it was released in June, July of 2018, and I have not been able to get my hands on it. This die is so hard to get. Unless you're stocking the stores every single day, it's going to be hard for you to get this. So I did want to go ahead and let you know. The first release from his Christmas collection, as far as the flower was concerned, was the solid poinsettia. And this one is part number, it's just the poinsettia. Here's the part number down here, JNDCC017. That is a little sample of his card. It comes in this kind of like heavy, it's not chipboard, it's like a thicker, it's a really heavyweight cardstock. I want to say it's at least like 130 pound weight, but it's the pocket style, kind of like the Spellbinders has changed to. It does have the little hanging tab. This is how it comes out. Again, this one was released in July of 2018. Depending on where you buy this one, in British gold pound, British pounds, it can range anywhere between 9.75 to 10.99, which roughly converts to about $12.33 to $13.90. So you're looking between $12 and $14 for this dye if you're converting it to US. Again, currency exchange rate is constantly changing, so that's kind of a ballpark figure. And that is for this one. He released this poinsettia this year for his Christmas release. This is part number JND132, and this is the swirl poinsettia. They do work together, or they can be used separately. I've seen them used separately. I don't particularly care for it. I would use this combined. So wanting this one, I didn't buy it because I couldn't find the original. And finally, I found a store online that had them in stock because I believe they just did restock about 2 weeks ago. This is October 11th. I think they restocked early October. So I finally was able to get them because I was not going to buy the swirl poinsettia if I couldn't get my hand on the original poinsettia. This one is about the same price. It ranges between 9.75 to 10.99 British pounds. Again, that converts to roughly $13 to $14 range for the swirl poinsettia. That is a sample of what it looks like. I do have one put together, so I can go ahead and show you. To coordinate with the solid poinsettia, you also have the poinsettia stamp. Part number for this is JND50013 Elegant Poinsettia. It's a large stamp set. You get the flowers that go with the die, and you get some additional sentiments. We have Happy Christmas, Merry Christmas, Have a Very, and this one says Happy New Year, and then you have some standalone poinsettia flowers for you to create, backgrounds or whatever you want to go ahead and create. This one is pricier than the dies. While the stamp is always nice to have, it's not necessary. You can create beautiful stuff without it. I personally like to have the coordinating stamps if there is one to go with my flower dies. It gives a different look. It adds more interest. It just depends what look you're going for. So, as far as the stamp set is concerned, it works fine. Lining up the stamp and the die had no issues whatsoever. Really, really easy. The only thing I'm going to say about the stamp, aside from the price, which if you're looking at British pounds, it's roughly around $14.99, which converts to about $18.95 US dollars. So the stamp is about $19. So price point wise, for me, that is a negative. It's pricey. It costs more than the die. So, and I get it, you have additional sentiments, so you add a higher price point, but that's just a down for me. I personally like them to be somewhat in the same range. Another negative about it is it smells. It smells terrible. It has the same smell that the Sue Wilson stamps have, the ones I have purchased, and I hate the smell. It's a very strong chemically type of smell. Maybe it's the type of material that these are. It doesn't say. I'll have to read up on what type of stamps these are. But yeah, they smell. So for me, if you have a sensitive nose like I do, you definitely won't like that. I know after a certain amount of time, the smell does tend to go away. As far as my Sue Wilson ones, I probably had them for a year and a half or so, and they still have. It's not as strong, but it's still there and it's still bothersome, so I don't use them as much. But positives for the stamp itself: easy to use, not an issue. Lining it up with the die is extremely easy, so that is a great pro when it comes to the stamp itself. Now, that's kind of about it. To get into more details about the dies, I like the fact that you have six different sizes on this die set. That is definitely a pro. A con for me is the fact that it's on this type of plate. I'm not a huge fan of plates like this. I prefer to have the border kind of like the Heartfelt Creation dies are. But this isn't bad. This is not the end of the world. I just particularly don't like it. I would say that the dyes are definitely nice. They're easy to use. They're not as strong as I expected them to be, but again, for the price point that they are, they're definitely not bad. They're not terrible quality, but they're definitely not the sturdiest plate you can find. Like for a good example in comparison to plates, Cottage Cuts does their dyes on plates. Those plates are sturdy. I mean, you ain't bending those, but you can definitely bend these. But again, that could be a pro and a con, the fact that it's on a plate. It's easier to line up. It matches up with the stamp set itself. And I've seen from all of his cutting plates like this that he has stamps, he cuts out the notches on his dies, which coordinate and line up with the lines on the stamp. I stamped an embossed one and the embossing powder actually got on there, so I was able to easily line it up. As you can see, you can go to the guide, line it up, and it's easy to go. Even if you didn't have these line up relatively easy, that it's pretty hard to not get it right. I had no issues with lining up my die with my stamp when I was cutting them. So the flowers, from what I've seen from all of his flower dies, come on a plate. I did buy another flower, and I will do a flower feature on that one as well after I'm done playing with it. So here is what the swirl looks like. This one is definitely thicker. You don't get the same bendable flexibility that you have on this, the solid poinsettia. And that could be that this one just needs more support because of the swirl. The swirl is beautiful, definitely a pro. I would say because of the nature of the detail of the die, it does take some effort to cut out. If you don't like putting that much effort into die cutting, then this die probably is not for you, but it's gorgeous. It's a gorgeous, gorgeous die, especially as a matting layer to the original poinsettia. When I was running this through my Big Shot, I have not run it. For example, I will tell you, I have not run this on my Platinum, and I also have not run it on my Gemini. I don't have a doubt that it won't have an issues running through the Gemini. Platinum, I'm not 100% sure, but I know the Big Shot, out of all of the machines I have, the Big Shot is the weakest machine. It takes the most effort when I use it, so I tend to not cut detail dies on my Big Shot. I have the Big Shot Plus. I also have the Big Shot Pro, but I haven't tried cutting this on the Pro. My Pro is sitting on the floor because it's heavy, so I rarely ever use the Pro unless I'm using really, really big dies. So through the Big Shot Plus, I ran it using the small platform. I ran it sideways one way, I brought it back, I turned it, and I brought it back that same way, and then I completely turned it so the plate went horizontal with the rollers. So I turned it, I cut it three different times, you know, three different passes, turning my base several times. And it still had some issues cutting it out. I did have to force some pieces out of it. The outside pieces of the die cut out beautifully, especially with running it three times. The inner pieces that were the hardest were some of the smaller ones. Well, can't really see it there. I'll show you in the die cut itself. So it did definitely take some effort, but once I find which machine it cuts best on, as well as if I need to shim. I didn't try shimming, all I did was try rotating, and I was cutting all of these out of Recollections 110-pound cardstock. So the weight of your cardstock will definitely depend on how easy these cut. I tend to use 100 to 110-pound cardstock. Again, all 100-pound and 110-pound cardstock is not created equally. Some of them are stiffer than others. Some of them have more flexibility. A good example is a Joann's Carries Park Lane 110-pound cardstock. I was so excited when I saw Joann's was carrying that, probably like a year, year and a half ago. I hate that cardstock. I hate it. It's awful. Other people might like it. I personally don't. If you compare it to the Recollections, Recollections is definitely stiffer, and I prefer that stiffer cardstock. Also comparable to Paper Tray Ink. Paper Tray Ink is really great quality. Again, it's also thinner. Even though it's still 110-pound, it's not the same. Recollections is still stiffer. Even one of my favorite brands, Pop Tone, they do 100-pound cardstock. I love that cardstock. I find it to be thicker and better quality than the paper tray and Kanchun 10. Again, don't get me wrong, I love paper tray and cardstock, even though it's not as thick. I love the colors, it's beautiful. So I'm just kind of giving comparison to the different cardstocks. Another really good one is ColorPlan. ColorPlan, I would say, is the same type of quality like paper tray and cardstock, not as thick as Poptone or Recollections, but definitely still really great. Those are my top three cardstock companies that I use. Recollections, Poptone, ColorPlan, four, and Paper Tree Ink. Those are my four go-to. But I haven't tried sampling it with the other cardstocks. I only tried it with Recollections since it is the stiffer cardstock that I have because I wanted to see how it would cut. The solid one cut beautifully on every single pass. I only had to... I have a habit of running it forward and then back again because it's 110-pound cardstock. But I don't think that it should have an issue just running it once, depending on how you line your the die itself. But it cuts really clean, no jagged, rough edges where it seems frayed, because you can definitely get that from some dies. That one did not have it, and I did cut them all out, again, through my Big Shot Plus. I did not try any of my other machines. So let me quit rambling about these, and let me go ahead and show you some samples. Okay, so... you know what? I didn't measure the smallest flower, but I did measure the largest. The largest flower is approximately 3 inches wide. This way. Well, one of the ways. Because the petals themselves are not identical. They definitely have a... they do have different shape. It's not proportional. Most of the poinsettia dies that I have are not proportional unless we're talking about Impression Obsession. This one reminds me of the Heartfelt Creations Sparkling Poinsettia. That was the first poinsettia that Heartfelt Creations brought out. This one reminds me a great deal of that one. These are just different sizes. I would say it's kind of got a little bit of a wonky type of shape. Not quite as wonky as the Tim Holtz Tattered Poinsettia. But it kind of gives me that vibe. So it gives me the petal shape. It gives me the vibe of the Heartfelt Sparkling Poinsettia. And then and the shape of it kind of reminds me of the Tattered Poinsettia from Tim Holtz. So it's kind of a mixture. But this is the largest one. It gives you 6 different sizes. So you can create a various amount of different size flowers from one die, which is definitely a plus. The negative thing that I always say about Heartfelt Creations is they always create 2 different sizes, a smaller version or a regular version, and then they have a larger version. So you have 2 different dies that retail for $30 a piece. If you get them on sale, of course, you can get them a little bit cheaper. And stamp sets retail for $20. You'll have a stamp set for the large and a stamp set for the small. So retail, you're looking at, let's see, that's 60 for the die. So you're looking at $100 if you're looking at retail if you want both sets. In reality, with different sales and such, you're probably going to be spending about $70 for the dies and the stamps. So these ones are a better price point. You're looking at, you know, $25 to $30 for the 6, you know, you get 6 different petal sizes, stamp set. So to me, that's a pro. You get more bang for your buck when it comes to the stamp and the dies. You get a much bigger variety as far as sizes are concerned with just one die. So you have the largest that runs at about 3 inches. The smallest one, I'm going to say this one's about 3/4 of an inch. Hold on. I'm trying to get my ruler from here. Yeah, I would say maybe 7/8 of an inch, probably almost close to 1 inch. You know what? If you're looking at point to point, you're about 1 inch wide, but it looks a lot smaller because of the shape. But yeah, you get tons of different little sizes. This is the solid petal. You can't see that, but that's getting on my nerves. This is the solid petal. So if you want to create flowers with just a solid piece, here you go. This is what it looks like stamped and embossed. I love to stamp and emboss my flowers. So that gives you the detail of the stamp itself. And this is what the swirl flower looks like, a die cut. Again, it's super gorgeous. Again, I see people just using the swirl poinsettia by itself. I personally don't like it on its own, so I won't use it on its own, but it's gorgeous. So those are the three different styles. Here you have a couple of different sizes. These are kind of the leftover pieces from when I die cut and I didn't use. So that's kind of what they look like, just cut out. Now for the flower themselves. Here is what the solid flower looks like with nothing. No stamping, no secondary die cutting, nothing in itself. So for this one, we have two of the largest petals. Then we have one of the petals in the next size down. And then one of the following petal, the smaller petal, in the center. And I just put three rhinestones in the center. That's what it looks like. You can definitely have a fuller flower or less. I notice a lot of people just do two layers. So two large and maybe a third piece, a smaller one down. I like really full flowers, so I'll pack it on there. But you can definitely use them in whatever manner that you like, however you like to create your flowers. So that's what it looks like. Here's another size for the flower. I just haven't added a center because I don't know if I want to put a filigree stamen in there or if I want to do the three rhinestones or three pearls. I don't know how I'm going to use this little flower yet, so I just haven't added the center piece. Now to look at the full flower stamped and embossed, here is what you got going on. And I definitely added more layers. We've got two of the base. Let me take a look. Two of the base, one of the next size down, then two of the one following that, and then we've got one in the center that's even smaller. So we got quite a few layers in this one. It's pretty full. And as you can tell, it's very, very busy because of the embossing. So a full flower like this with all this detail embossing, you could have a more simple background. If you have a busier background with stamping, embossing, or pattern paper, you're probably better going off with a solid piece to ground it a little bit more with all the busyness in the background. With this one, super busy, you want to have a softer background for this flower here. So that's what they look like. If you were to just get the die set, the original poinsettia die set and the stamp. So then we're going to go ahead and bring in the poinsettia with the two layers. I use the original poinsettia as well as the swirl poinsettia. This one definitely has different, less layers. This one only has three, and I shaped this one just a tad bit different. So my go-to shaping is to cup the petals upward. This one here, you fold the petals down. Same type of forming as this one. It's just the direction that you're gluing the flower down. I notice a lot of people who use the Sue Wilson poinsettia as well as this one, they like to do this version where they cup the petals and they go down versus me, I like to go up, but this is still gorgeous. So an example for that. So here is a flat petal. I love to use tweezers. These are my go-to flower shaping for every single flower that I do. I have several of these tweezers because with my long nails, they definitely become essential when trying to deal with small areas that my nails can't get into. So my standard way, I put the petal into my tweezers. It doesn't matter how far down you go. It all depends on how much you want to cup it. If you only want to cup the edges, you have it further down. You know, so usually I kind of go 3/4 of the way. I grab the sides of the petal and I pinch up. And that's how you go and you get the shaping for your flower. As you can see, it just gives it a little bit of dimension, not too much. And I just go through, fold it up, and it doesn't even have to be perfect. I just go through super quick, fold it up. And of course, because I'm on camera, it keeps jamming. And I just take the different petals, I grab the sizes that I want, and I offset each time I do the flower. So another way that you can do it that's exactly the same way, that gives you a different look. Take the top of your flower, whichever side you're going to have going up. I flip it upside down. So this is the back piece of my flower, because you can tell the difference when you die cut, which side is the front and which is the back. I flip it over so the back is facing up, and then I do the exact same motion. I fold it up. The only difference is when I go through to adhere all of my flowers, you're going to take the flower, you're going to flip it over, and you're going to start gluing them and offsetting them, and that gives you a different shaping to the flowers with the way that the petals go. Again, if you want to kind of take a look at a close-up, I mean, you might not be able to see the difference of how it looks on camera. I mean, I think you can. So if you can see, let's turn this on its side. You can see the shaping has a spikiness going up. And this one here, it's just a little bit different. Again, it's harder to see on video, but you can tell the difference in person. But that's what they look like. So that is kind of it on my review for the flower. Again, there's lots of things that I like about this. I will definitely use it. I really love this one. I think I'm going to use this one quite a bit. I'll probably use this one as well. The flower is gorgeous. It's a great price point overall when you're looking at everything. With the 6 different petals, again, you can get flowers ranging anywhere from 3 inches down to 1 inch. So you definitely have a lot of room to play with and have multiple sizes to create different size poinsettias from that one die. The stamp, again, it's not necessary. I see it as a bonus. It's a perk, so if you can get it, awesome. But it's not a requirement. These 2 versions that you get with the original die are still gorgeous. And if you want the secondary die, which is the swirl one, these are gorgeous. But I personally think that all 3 options give you great different looking flowers. I love poinsettias. I use all of my poinsettia dies. With that being said, I will still say that my number one favorite poinsettia is definitely the Sue Wilson one. But this one takes a close second. I really, really, really love this. And if they continue the same thing like Sue Wilson does, where she started out with her original solid poinsettia, and then they started creating additional layering pieces that you can either use alone or it would coordinate with the original one. If John continues to do that, I would definitely continue to buy the additional poinsettia layering sets. Again, you can use the, for me, they're layering sets. Everybody else uses them as either individual or as layering. It all depends up to you. So I think you can get a great variety out of the different type of flowers. Again, price point is good. It's definitely a pro. Not that many cons in my opinion. And the cons aren't really that bad to the point where for me, I can definitely overlook them and I will definitely get them. I would say the only one negative thing that will definitely be a turnoff to other people is the fact that you can't get it here in the States. Lots of people don't want to shop overseas. I will link some stores in the description box below where you can find them. I will tell you that the original poinsettia is still extremely difficult to find. And it makes me wonder if they're going to retire this original one. Because when dies get increasingly difficult and aren't restocked as frequently, that's usually a good tell, a tell sign that they're on the way out the door. So if you can find this, definitely, definitely get it. And I wanted to go ahead and do a flower feature series, even though in the back of my head, I think they're planning on retiring this, is because it was recently restocked. So if you can find it, grab it. I know the sites that I will be listing, I did look as I'm recording this video, they did not have them in stock. But continue, put yourself on the emailing list to see if it does come back. Because if it does, I recommend you picking it up. The swirl poinsettia just came out this year, so it should definitely be around a lot longer. Again, you're just going to have to wait for the restock. It's still a relatively new die, so you're probably going to have a hard time finding it. But again, like I said, keep a lookout. It's a gorgeous flower. Great sizes, and it'll give you a different look when you change up the different poinsettias that you have. Okay, oh my god, this video is 30 minutes long. I'm going to shut up now. I think that's about it. If you have any questions, please feel free to comment. Let me know. I do appreciate the support for those of you who do comment and who do like my videos. It definitely lets me know who's watching when I see those comments. If there's a flower out there that you want me to do a feature on that you don't have that I could possibly have and you kind of want to know more details about it, just comment below and let me know what flower it is and I'll let you know if I have it. And if I do, I'll do a feature series on it for it to give you some ideas. Okay, again, check out the description box below to see the links of the UK retailers who I have purchased from myself who carry John Next Door range, so you can keep an eye out to see if they restock. That's going to be Maximum Crafts, and that's the one who has the cheapest shipping out of all of the different sites. They have a flat rate of £2.95 British pounds to ship to the United States. It's a flat rate, so it's not like based on weight as you would Craft for Less, which is, used to be Craft World Online. They are now Craft for Less. It goes by weight. You have a starting shipping fee, and the more you add, the more your shipping goes up. Craft Stash is the same way. I order for them. I have no issues, but again, they're the same thing. Your shipping increases and goes up based on how much you're adding. So the flat shipping fee from Maximum Crafts is definitely a way to go if you're buying a lot of stuff. But again, I've purchased from all three vendors. They are all great. So definitely go ahead and check them out. And they all do carry the John Next Door range. There are a few other dies from John Next Door that I did get, and I'll be featuring some cards. I might do a die feature series on one of them because it's an awesome die. So yeah, stay tuned. Again, it's a new company for me, so I'm definitely going to be playing with them a lot more. And they do have some beautiful designs out there. So go ahead and check out the John Next Door range through all of these different sites. And check out his blog. I'll link his blog in the description box below as well. He does gorgeous, gorgeous cards. So go ahead and check his out. And I will catch you guys in another video. Thanks so much for watching. Bye.